The Stranger from Pecos, starring Johnny Mac Brown, a 1943 U.S. one-sheet poster, which didn't always look this good.
It's got some paper tape on the back, which we're going to remove.
We inspect the backs of posters to make sure that there is no tape on the back. Sometimes the tape is obvious, sometimes it is not. And what's more is whatever sticky residue there is needs to be removed.
This Johnny Mac Brown poster has got some heavy creasing in the folio folds. This is a beautiful lithograph.
One of the interesting things about this poster is that its printing is lithography and not offset. The plates are probably zinc plates, and you can see by the way the rendering is that there is no mechanical dot pattern, but rather a random pattern made by hand-manipulated drawing. The United States stopped doing this kind of lithography in the 1940s. This is one of the last good examples of the kind of lithography done in America prior to World War I. Johnny Mac Brown was born in 1904 and died in 1974, and he was an American college football player, and he was also well known as Johnny Mac Brown, the film actor who did a lot of westerns. Born and raised in Dothan, Alabama. His handsome looks and physique got him a gig on Wheaties cereal boxes, and in 1927 brought an offer for a motion picture screen test, which resulted in a long and successful career in Hollywood. That same year, he signed a five-year contract with MGM, and he played silent film star Mary Pickford's love interest in her first talkie, Coquette, in 1929, for which she won an Oscar. He appeared in minor roles until 1930, when he was cast the star in a western entitled Billy the Kid and directed by King Vidor. He was tested to play Tarzan, but he didn't get that role. I don't think he's remembered as well as John Wayne or Clint Eastwood today, although people who were around at his time might still remember him. There were an awful lot of cowboys, and in those days, cowboy movies were the top most popular genre, most likely, outside of musicals. So it's not surprising that we haven't remembered as well as we should some of these Western stars. What I love about old lithography is that the colors are always so vibrant. A lithographer could interpret a piece of artwork onto a lithographic plate and have a lot of control over the way the color was distributed and blended to create the maximum effects. These lithographers were masters at what they did, and it's a lost art today.
Good job, Jinbei. Stranger from Pecos will dry for a few days before we restore it and trim it down, or trim it down and restore it, as the case may be. Thank you.
This is Chris. Thanks for joining me.